thought I'd talk about Kronic. I'm very pleased to see that the government has moved to ban Kronic and similar products from our dairies. I got a bit upset a couple of weeks ago when I bowled into our local dairy right across the road from the high school and found that they were selling Kronic and advertising it all the way down to about 2 feet off the pavement. So even a little three-year-old walking in to the dairy holding his mum's hand was face to face with someone who was smoking weed. And I'm very pleased to see that what the government's done is to ban it from the end of this week and then put an onus back onto those who are marketing and manufacturing it to prove that it's safe before it's sold. There's too many of our dairy owners who are quite happy to sell this sort of stuff to people on the basis that it's not illegal or it hasn't been until now. We can't rely on these people always to do what's best for our communities, and it's up to us community people to take a lead. I want to talk too about the 17th of September and the Real Whanganui Art exhibition that is on for a period of about 6 weeks leading through the whole period of the Rugby World Cup. This is one of the Rugby World Cup parallel events that's running, and the government's put $110,000 into Whanganui to assist with this project. On the 17th of September in the War Memorial car park, we're having a big paint where a number of people will paint canvases, and they'll all be constructed on the side of the War Memorial Hall to create a huge mural. The Minister of Arts, Culture and Heritage, the Honourable Chris Finlayson, will be there with me, and we'll be painting, and it's a great day for people to come along and spend some time there. There's also the New Zealand Literacy Awards on at that time as well, and so people are welcome to come along and listen to those events and attend the lectures by writers and presenters, and I encourage people to come along to that. It's a great event that's coming up on our calendar. And I'd like to just finish off, I guess, by talking about early childhood education. The government's had a bit of a smacking from the Labor side of the House about early childhood education. They've been saying that we've been involved in cuts. What they fail to say, of course, is that the government is putting more money into early childhood education than it ever has before. At the moment, just in educating the under fives, the government's putting in about $1.4 billion into those young kids. That's more than the whole police budget, to give you an idea of scale. Personally, I don't mind that, because the more money we put into those young ones now, the less we're likely to need in a police budget in years to come. Fact is that when Labor kicked off the 20 hours early childhood free education, they budgeted it $440 million. By the time they left office, they were spending $660 million on it, and last year it went up to $1.4 billion, so it's huge. National has decided to take that last $100 million, which is, so cap the funding for early childhood at $1.3 million, and then take that other $100 million, which would have taken up to $1.4 million, and target those young kids who aren't making their way to ECE at the moment. Unfortunately, in a number of low decile homes mainly, we find that these young people aren't accessing early childhood education. The single best thing we can do to keep a young child from being a negative statistic in health and welfare and education and law and order in the future is to engage them in early childhood education early. So in the Whanganui area, we've got 2,500 under fives with registered early childhood educators, and that's a really good thing. What we want to do now is target that extra funding to make sure that every child can access it. When we came into government, we also brought play centres in Te Kohanga Rau into the 20 hours free scheme, so that they got more children coming to them, and again it increased the catchment of young people attending those early childhood centres, and that's a really great thing. At the moment, the Kohanga Rau are getting a bit upset and saying, look, we're not so much about early childhood education as we are about protecting our language. That's all very well, but we've got to have some measures on this, and if we're going to fund it through education, there need to be some measures. So there may be some arguments around that. Quite honestly, the government says we're going to continue funding it, but we're going to make sure that people actually have some criteria around what they're teaching and what they're teaching our young people. So the government has said it's going to continue with 20 hours free education for the under five. It's going to continue funding them at this level. It's going to expand those who can achieve it, and it's going to target with extra money those young people who are currently missing out on early childhood education. We've got to do the most for our kids. They are not only our future, they are our today.